Health boards are in charge of overseeing health districts, and they make decisions about hiring and firing health officers and administrators. Under current law, they're made up mostly of county commissioners, and those commissioners in turn can decide to add more people to the board. In Spokane, that includes 6 other elected leaders and 3 members who aren't elected officials. The firing of Spokane's previous health officer and the chaos that surrounded it led many, like Representative Marcus Riccelli, to ask, are local health boards too political?
Well, I think the consequences are clear. Medicine and science don't lead in times when they should be leading.
He and several other representatives have proposed changing the state law. This proposal would require that at least half of every board of health is made up of non-politicians. The new members must fit 1 of 4 categories, drawing equally from each: healthcare providers, public health workers, people who have experienced inequity in healthcare, and general community stakeholders like nonprofit or business leaders.
The diversity of experience and lived experience is important. We got to make sure not only there are healthcare representatives and public health representatives, but people with lived experience. Public health affects some of our most marginalized communities, some of our most vulnerable populations, and that is also an important piece to make sure their voices are being heard and represented on these boards of health.
In Spokane's case, that would mean the board would likely grow to 18 people to make an even number of elected and unelected members. Riccelli says other counties have concerns similar to Spokane's, so making boards of health less political is a statewide issue right now. This particular bill may not be the final law, but he's optimistic something like it will be included in legislation this session.
We'll move forward on something around the governance issue. I'm feeling confident that there's a lot of energy, enthusiasm around it, particularly in a pandemic. And we've really shown the importance of balancing our health boards with non-elect officials. It's just common sense, right? We don't want people who have no background sometimes in public health or healthcare to be making all the decisions.
Casey Decker, Crem 2 News.